subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson. Today, let us discuss about the structural differences between sympathetic and parasympathetic neural systems. Compare the origin. So, sympathetic neural system arise from the thoracic and lumbar regions of the spinal cord. That's why the flow is known as thoracolumbar outflow, as the information goes from the thoracic and lumbar regions to the target organs. Coming to parasympathetic neural system, so it originates from the cranial nerves and the sacral nerves of the spinal cord. So the outflow is known as craniosacral outflow. So the cranial nerves 3, 7, 9 and 10 and sacral nerves 2, 3 and 4 are involved in craniosacral outflow. Ganglion. So the ganglia linked to form chain and they are very close to the spinal cord. That's why these ganglia of the sympathetic neural system is known as sympathetic chain ganglia or paravertebral ganglia. These are connected to the one and other. So the ganglia here in parasympathetic neural system are isolated. So they are present as a single structure and they are very close to the target organs, are present inside the target organs. So that is the difference. Compared to the ganglionic fibers. So preganglionic fibers of sympathetic neural system are short and postganglionic fibers are very long. It is entirely opposite when we compare the parasympathetic neural system. Parasympathetic neural system preganglionic fibers are very long and postganglionic fibers are short. Neurotransmitter. So the postganglionic neurons release adrenaline as a neurotransmitter, that hence the system is known as adrenergic system. Here in parasympathetic neural system, the postganglionic neurons release acetylcholine. That's why the system is known as cholinergic system. So the condition when the sympathetic neural system is activated is during stressful conditions and fear condition or fight or flight situations. Parasympathetic neural system is antagonistic. So it is active during the resting period and it calms down the excited body. So next, the effect. The effect of the sympathetic neural system is excitatory. So it excites the different organs to prepare the body for fight or flight situations. And the effect is widespread because postganglionic fibers are long. In parasympathetic neural system, the effect is inhibitory. So it calms down the system. So the excited system will be calmed down and it is bring to the resting condition by the parasympathetic neural system, and the effect is local or limited. So as the postganglionic fibers are shorter, that's why the effect is local and limited. So these are some of the differences between sympathetic neural system and parasympathetic neural system. So by the antagonistic properties of sympathetic and parasympathetic neural system, they bring homeostasis in the body. Hope you understand. Happy studying. In this lesson, we are going to learn about the effects of parasympathetic and sympathetic neural system on some organs. So, parasympathetic system is a inhibitory system. Sympathetic system is a excitatory system. So, how these organs respond to the sympathetic impulse and how they are respond to the parasympathetic impulses, we compare both of them. Now, so sympathetic system is an excitatory system. So, in the neurotransmitter is a noradrenaline. So, the pupil of the eye dilates. So, more amount of light will enter into the eye so that the person can see the surroundings very clear. During parasympathetic impulse, the pupil will be constricted. So only the less amount of light is enters. So the body is in resting stage. The pupils will constrict. So in the sympathetic system, the salivary glands inhibit salivation. So here salivation is inhibited and lungs will dilated, bronchi and lungs will be dilated. So more oxygen enters into the lungs so that the muscles are supplied with the oxygen. So heart, here heart will be accelerated. So heartbeat rate will be increased so that more amount of blood will be pumped out and more oxygen supplied to the organs. So and stomach, it inhibits the digestion, so the energy will be conveyed to the muscles, not to the digestive system. And the liver, here the liver, in the liver it stimulates the glucose release. So glucose is a energy giving substances. So glucose formation will be stimulated in the liver during the sympathetic innervation. And the kidneys here stimulate epinephrine. So here adrenal glands, epinephrine and norepinephrine will be released. And the kidneys, the urine formation will be inhibited. In the intestine also, peristalsis and all will be inhibited. Bladder will be relaxed. So all these are the functions which are helpful for a person to fight or flight. So after excitation of the body, all these organs will be calmed down and come to the relaxed position by the parasympathetic nervous system. So the pupil of the eye will be constricted, stimulate the salivation, and heartbeat will be slow down. So here the heartbeat slows down means it does not slow down below the 72 beats. The normal heartbeats are 72 beats per minute. Here excitation means the heartbeat number will be increased. That is, it goes to 80, 90 and 100 also. But here it does not, it means it does not slow down to below normal, that is below 72. It brings the heartbeat rates to the 72 beats per minute. So you have to remember, slow down means not below the 72 beats per minute, okay. So here constriction of the bronchi during resting period, no more oxygen is not needed, so the trachea and the bronchi will be constrict, and the digestion in the stomach will be stimulated, and bile release occurs in the liver, and the intestine peristaltic movement will be stimulated, and bladder will be contract and the urine will be released during the resting position. So the parasympathetic and sympathetic neural systems perform antagonistic function, that is the opposite functions. If you remember the functions during the sympathetic innervation, so you write the opposite for that, so then parasympathetic functions will easily remembered. Hope you understand the lesson.